guys have three point guards, but then also Alexa Middleton's almost been another point guard through the first two games for you guys. How crucial has that play been for you?
I think it's been huge just with the depth and whatever kind of look the coaches are trying to go for in a certain game, we can do that. And just makes it easier because it doesn't matter who gets the rebound, it's whichever guard is closest to the ball can push it and the rest of us can get out and run.
Ariel, with these guards, with all these guards, what are your marching orders? What are they telling you they want you doing when you're in the game?
Push the tempo, run the team, so how they tell me my roles are. I think we can do that with the amount of guards and don't have to play a lot of minutes to worry about getting tired because you can easily get a sub because there are so many of us and get you a quick break and come back in.
Is there things you're thinking about in terms of how you're playing out there other than that, hey, I got to do this too or I'm coming out? Or what goes through your mind in that regard?
I don't think so. Just playing the game like I know to play. I've been doing this for 3 years now, so I think I got a good feel of what Holly wants and looks for in a point guard. Like I said, just pushing the tempo, knocking down the open shots when they double team or guard our post players hard, and just being aggressive and being consistent on the defensive end.
Do you have to be a scoring threat? I mean, is that something that you have to really be mindful of, take shots and make your share to stay out there?
I think everyone on the team from the guard position has to make shots. I think that's what makes us so good is that everyone is capable of doing that. It allows our post more freedom. You know, if they can't double down the post because guards are making shots, it makes it easier on them. So I think something we've been working on, I was playing inside out, and I think we've been doing a good job at it up until this point.
Did you feel any rust at all the other night, or was it just once you got in there you were fine? Or?
Oh, I was fine. I was just excited. I think I might have been running on a lot of adrenaline that night, but my body's had a long time to rest. I'm feeling good and, you know, just ready and looking forward to the season.
How much do you think it helped the younger players to get some time early when some of you had to sit out?
I think it helped a lot. Their confidence is way up there right now. And, you know, just us coming back, bringing that experience to the team with their work ethic and their energy and how hard that they play is only going to make us that much better.
Coach Warlick said before the season she wanted to work her offense through Izzy. And with Izzy not out there, how do you think Nia and Bashara are stepping up?
Oh, they stepped up tremendously. And I think that's what makes us so good. You know, we always had Izzy there, and she challenges them every day in practice. And they watch her. They learn from her. They talk to her. So she's been a great leader for them in the post.
Ariel, could you go back a little bit to last year and what you went through to get back here? I mean, how difficult was it at times to get to recover, and what are some of the things you went through?
It was very difficult. I think after the first couple weeks of the concussion, kind of realizing that my season probably was over and that I wasn't going to be able to play again. And so I think once I finally realized that, I changed my mindset and just thought about how I could affect the team and help the team win by not being on the court. And I think my leadership skills stepped up, just being more encouraging, being a great teammate. And, you know, with the knee injury, surgery, just rehabbing and wanting to get back and working hard with, you know, Lee and Ashley in the training room and in the weight room, just trying to get myself back ready for this season. So
is the knee good?
The knee is good. The knee is feeling really good. Knee's good. Head is good. I'm excited and looking forward to the senior season.
When's the last time you felt as good as you do now?
I'd probably say before I got hurt with the head. Before then, I didn't have any injuries. I was feeling good before that concussion happened. So probably back to beginning of junior year.
But your knee was okay then?
Yes.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. The team is off to a really nice start. What are some things that the team needs to work on as you guys go through this early season portion of your schedule?
I think we have to work on being more consistent. We have a lot of stretches during the game where we're playing extremely well, and then we tend to have some lulls sometimes, and I think that comes with, you know, our inexperience that was out there. But I think just getting more game experience and playing in different games, we'll learn that. And I think this team just has to be consistent. That's been kind of our bad leg since I've been here. You know, we show good spurts at times, but we have to be consistent.
Have the coaches or the team talked amongst themselves about with these early games where you're going to be clearly a prohibitive favorite, of playing to a standard, like you know, almost like competing against yourselves, and like we want to play to this standard and set a standard? Season.
We make goals for ourselves, whether it be, you know, we're going to have 12 or less turnovers for a game, or let's try to get so many offensive rebounds, or let's force our opponent team into so many amount of turnovers. So I think that definitely helps us just to hold ourselves to that standard, and that's something that we've been talking about.
Did you get to see the end of the UConn-Stanford game the other night? Or
I did.
What was your reaction? I mean, clearly they were seen as such an overwhelming favorite going into the season. When you see them lose early on, is there any reaction just in terms of maybe this being a little more wide open than you thought? Or
I just think that's the joy of basketball. You know, the the stat sheets, and they say a lot about a team, but what you do in between those 40 minutes in between the quarter really what matters.